Violence against women and girls is one of the most prevalent human rights violations in the world. A 2016 United Nations Global Database report on violence against women shows that 51% of women have experienced lifetime physical or sexual intimate partner violence. 35% have experienced physical or sexual intimate partner violence in the last 12 months, while 4% have experienced lifetime non-partner sexual violence. The report also shows that 40% of children have been married off before the age of consent, and female genital mutilation accounts for 1%.
Crimes of gender-based violence are of extreme urgency because the victims live with the perpetrators.
According to the Director of Public Prosecutions, Mike Chivita, Uganda has improved in the struggle to have these percentages drop.
More specific laws have been passed to address the different new offences. Now, we need to be sensitizing the prosecutors and the judges as these new laws are passed, that don't just restrict yourself to the penal code. There are other offences created by these new laws.
However, Center for Domestic Violence Prevention, a women's rights activists group, feels more must be done to pursue justice for women.
So I think that also ties in with a proposal that you say has been made about setting up a special court. Because once that special court is set up, then they will know that their primary piece of legislation is the Domestic Violence Act.
Gender-based violence undermines the health, dignity, security and autonomy of its victims, yet it remains shrouded in a culture of silence. Victims of violence can suffer sexual and reproductive health consequences, including forced and unwanted pregnancies, unsafe abortions, traumatic fistula, sexually transmitted infections, including HIV, and even death. Walter Mwesije, NTV.